I'm Kim Coleman, a co-founder here at Paid Memberships Pro. Let's walk through the setup wizard for Paid Memberships Pro. The first screen asks us to select a type of membership site that we're creating. You can leave this field blank, but if you do know what type of site you're creating from one of our 8 use cases, you can choose it here. This choice will show up later in the setup wizard with some recommended add-ons that are applicable to your use case. I'm going to say I'm creating a community membership site. The wizard also asks if you'd like the plugin to generate the required plugin pages. Most sites that are just setting up Paid Memberships Pro should keep this box checked. Otherwise, you'll need to manually create some required plugin pages later as part of just going through the normal settings. So I'm going to leave this checked. You can optionally select whether you plan to collect payment for memberships. So if you're setting up a paid membership site and check this box, the setup wizard will take you through some of your gateway setup, but also this can be done later. So I'm going to leave this unchecked and just set up a free membership as part of this wizard. The last field is for people that already have a premium membership key or license key for Paid Memberships Pro. This field is completely optional. The core plugin that you've installed and downloaded from WordPress.org is a very complete plugin. It's really the most complete membership plugin you'll find out there, free or paid. But a license key would allow you to install additional add-ons and update add-ons that might already be installed in your site. Some of our add-ons are premium add-ons and a lot of them are free. So go to our website and you can see a link in the description for all the various add-ons you can install with Paid Memberships Pro and if they are free or premium upgrade. But I'm not going to enter a license key here. For this initial setup, everything we're doing is all part of the complete core plugin. Because we didn't set up any payments in that first step, it skips step 2 of the wizard. If you were setting up payments as part of the wizard process, you would then go through that screen and connect an account, gateway account there. But we're going to set up just a free level as part of this initial setup. So if I check this box to create a level, I can call this my basic tier or whatever other name you want to name your membership levels as that part. And then there's just a notice here that content restrictions will be happening later in this tutorial. The next screen in the setup wizard has to do with your advanced settings. There are tons more advanced settings for Paid Memberships Pro. If you just wanted to look at a few of the most important ones, we've highlighted them here in the setup wizard. The first one is whether you want to filter searches and archives. This has to do with whether a member can see, a non-member can see posts that are not available to them that they don't have the correct membership for on your blog page or in search or maybe in a category or tag archive. Some sites are very restrictive in that they don't want non-members to discover that there's premium content, even if that content is protected. They want to keep it hidden from the normal view. Other sites want to show that premium content as part of the normal blog or archive page so that non-members can stumble upon premium content and get enticed to upgrade on something that they can't see. So pretty common that you'd want to change this setting to know that you want protected content to show up in searches and archives. But a lot of people by default would be confused. Why is my premium content still showing to non-members? So we always default on the side of protect first and hide stuff first, and then you can decide how much you want to use your premium content as like a leader or teaser for your site. So I'll leave my filtered searches and archives set to yes. The other option would be no, that non-members would see that there are restricted posts unavailable to them. This next setting is similar. It has to do with whether an excerpt of protected members-only content shows to non-members. So if you have a 2,000-word article about stock tips for 2024 fall, you could say, oh, non-members can't see anything. They can't even see the excerpt of that content. Alternately, you could change this setting to yes to say, okay, we'll allow non-members to see like the first section of that content. By default, I think WordPress is like 250 words, something like that is the excerpt. And you can custom define that. It also might be impacted by your theme. I'll leave this set to no, but you can always change these settings later if you decide to change your content strategy related to how your premium content is displayed to non-members. This field here allows you to block access to a customized view of the WordPress admin area, which is what we're seeing here, based on the role of the user. We have some good tutorials about WordPress user roles. Memberships are something entirely different. User roles are built into WordPress, and that just controls what features of WordPress can users access at different role tiers. So a subscriber role is allowed to edit their own user profile, like their name, email address, their password, and change things like that. Obviously, they can't publish content to your site or update settings or anything like that. So Paid Memberships Pro includes a feature to say, don't even let them go into this customized view of the WordPress admin. So that's your choice. You can check that box to block all these users from accessing the dashboard. Additionally, you can block the subscriber role, which is that base user role, from seeing this black toolbar at the top of your site. I like to check both of these boxes. I just think it creates the most seamless experience for subscribers and members that they don't really need to see some of these features. There's other ways that they can edit their profile as part of Paid Memberships Pro. This last field is really a benefit to us as a company, but it will benefit you as well. If you wish to allow us to track non-sensitive membership site data, that helps us just analyze how is our plugin working for you? Is it meeting your expectations? Are there things that are sticky and that we need to improve? Or are there very popular settings that we want to double down on and make easier to use? So you can set this to yes if you opt into these non-sensitive tracking, or no if you do not want to track access. That is the initial setup. That's the setup wizard. These are customized for community add-ons that we could use, like an approval process. We can go to the front end of the site and see that. We can go into documentation, or we can just return to our membership dashboard. Let's check out what happened after completing the setup wizard for Paid Memberships Pro. I'm going to click on my site to go to the front end of my site, and you'll see the generated pages are showing up here in this default menu. We probably want to customize it and just have certain pages visible, but let's see if we can check out for membership. I'm going to click on my membership levels page and see that basic level we created during our setup wizard is available now. I can select this level and come to the checkout page. We are already logged in, so it's not asking for any additional information. I can submit this checkout, and I'm already a member of the site. If I view my membership account, I'll be able to click through to edit my profile and add my information. I could change my password from this screen or log out, and then I can see what membership levels are active for my account. Currently, we have one level available that we just completed checkout for, which was our basic free level. I could go through a cancellation process if I wanted to terminate my membership. And I can also see the order history for my account. So I've only made one purchase on the site. It was a free checkout and it was $0. It had no payment method, and this just shows who I was billed to. There's no other orders for my membership account. That kind of takes you through a walkthrough of what we got set up after the initial setup wizard. A free membership level, all of those front-end plugin pages set up, and the ability to accept a new user registration and give them a free basic membership. The next video in this tutorial is going to walk through setting up a paid membership level and a few additional settings in the back end of Paid Memberships Pro.